The RGV official rock station. Q94.5. All rock, all the time.
You're listening to Homebrewed, sponsored by 5x5 Brewing Company. And today on the line we have Overt Enemy, made up of Rob Hahn, Jaime Ayala, Leo, and Laura Ortiz. And right now I got Leo. And Leo, tell me, how has coronavirus affected Overt Enemy?
Well, we haven't gotten together. We've been trying to get online and do this little Zoom session where we get, you know, three or four of us connected into a Rob system there. And, you know, it worked out pretty good. We had one or two little sessions like that. And it's getting better from what I hear. But other than that, we are working on a couple of newer songs that we're trying to get ready for this new EP that we're putting together. The COVID has slowed it all down. We're working on some music. We got some new stuff coming up. There's a lot of great material that we got. It's a good time right now, actually, for us to just kind of look in the mirror and kind of, you know, discover ourselves as our own type of musicians. Like the other day, I was sitting here just jamming out and just playing, you know, stuff that I would not normally play, but it really helped me open up my mind as far as creativity and stuff. So yeah, we got a lot of good stuff that we're looking forward to letting out. And as soon as this COVID, you know, is over, as soon as this whole stay at home crap is over, I'm definitely going to get the band together and maybe, you know, sweat it out for a couple of 2 or 3 hours.
I'm here talking to Overt Enemy. Make sure you check out their website, overtenemy.com. And Mr. Rob Hahn, tell me, what's in the future for Overt Enemy?
While it definitely has been a challenge getting together and doing the normal, you know, band thing that we're used to doing for writing and all of that, we've been pretty busy on other fronts. We managed to get a song placed in an independent horror movie called 5G Zombies. And that is going to be available worldwide on Amazon Prime.
5G Zombies. All right. Sounds good.
And that's from SCS Entertainment in California. They put out tons of independent horror movies. They used one of our other songs, Blood God, in a movie called Jaws in Los Angeles, which hasn't been released yet. But 5G Zombies is kind of interesting because it was all filmed during the quarantine. And it's a bit of a collaboration with a lot of different people. We're pretty excited to be part of it. It's really neat. And people will be able to check it out at 5gzombies.com or get on Amazon Prime and do a search for it.
5gzombies.com. Okay. And then you have a vinyl project.
Yeah, we've been getting asked pretty much since we started putting out original music when we were going to release a record. What we decided to do is we're going to combine both of our EPs into one vinyl release, so basically the equivalent of a full length, and that should be out sometime in August. So if you go to our Facebook page or any of our social media, just stay tuned or look at go to overtenemystore.com and sign up for our mailing list, and we'll be sending out the notification when the pre-order goes live. And you never know, we might end up putting an extra new song on there. You know, if the COVID gods will let us actually get in the studio and record something.
You're listening to Homebrewed, sponsored by 5x5 Brewing Company, located in Mission, Texas, here with Overt Enemy. And you guys play some very heavy music, and it's really, really good. And let's go back to the beginning. How did it all start? How did you guys get introduced to rock? And let's go down the line and introduce yourselves. So, Rob, talk to me.
Hey, well, this is Rob. I'm the guitarist. I'd say what inspired me to play music was a lot of classic rock. My dad got me into bands like Jimi Hendrix and Queen and Van Halen and acts like that. And then I discovered metal, and as soon as I found Megadeth and Metallica and Slayer, I was like, yeah, I want to learn how to make that noise. And that's been my story ever since.
Let's hear from drummer extraordinaire Jaime Ayala.
Hey, what's up, everybody? This is Jaime Ayala, the drummer for Overt Enemy. And for me, growing up, actually, I kind of knew as a kid that I was always going to be a rock band. I remember listening to Kiss when I was very young, and I've been into the rock scene ever since. And I was a big fan. I always was a big fan of Metallica, Megadeth, Sepultura. And I went from there and started drumming when I was... Actually, I didn't start drumming until I was in my early 20s. Eventually, I ended up meeting Rob and Leo and the guys, and we became very good friends.
Thanks a lot, Jaime. And, you know, that's actually inspirational to hear that you started drumming so late. I mean, that's actually impressive. Mr. Leo Ortiz, talk to me.
What started me down this path of heavy metal, sex, drugs, and rock and roll, man? I mean, my instrument, I mean, I have to stick with the guitar. I'm multi-talented, if you want to say. I play guitar, I play the drums, I play bass, I do vocals and stuff. But when I started out just rocking out on the guitar, man. And the number one influence, I mean, it sticks to the back of my head, like, all the time. I have to say, is when I first saw those Channel 60, you know, PBS free concerts, and I saw Stevie Ray Vaughan, dude, tearing it up. I mean, just tearing it up. Breaking strings, switching guitars, jumping all over. I mean, that just that you know, the expressions on his face, the way he just, you know, let all that music just flow through him. I wanted that. And I wanted to sound good, too.
Well, now let's hear from Laura Slayrella Ortiz. Talk to me, Laura.
Hey, yeah, this is Laura. I'm the bassist for Over at Enemy. And my background's a little bit different. I grew up listening to country music. You know, I listened when I was little, my mom raised me on K-Frog. And then one day we turned on the radio and K-Frog wasn't there anymore. There was this other little, you know, radio station called Q94.5 The Rock. And that was when I was really introduced to classic rock and the rock scene. And then in high school, I got introduced to, you know, Metallica and Pantera. And that's really where my love of rock grew. Cliff Burton and Rex Brown were big influences. You know, one of the reasons why I wanted to pick up the bass. But I really didn't pick up the bass until much later in life. You know, I was already married, already had all of my kids, and then I picked up the bass.
You're listening to Homebrewed, sponsored by 5x5 Brewing Company, located in Mission, Texas, talking to Overt Enemy. And I got drummer extraordinaire on the line, Jaime Ayala of Overt Enemy. And I understand you guys have a gig coming up. Tell me about that.
Well, as of now, it's on, and hopefully it'll stay on. We have a show coming up at Cine Rey in McAllen on July 11th, and that's the Metal God tribute show. That three. This is going to be our third one. They've been great. The past two, Metal Gods 1 and 2, have been great. We've had real good turnouts. As of now, as far as we know, this is going to be the only scheduled concert that is still going on in the area here in the Valley. And we'd like everybody to come out and support. However, since everything right now is still going back into, trying to get back into a normal way of life, things are, it's going to be a limited amount of seating at Cine Rey. So because of that, we're going to be having to limit the amount of tickets that we're going to put out. So we encourage you all to go ahead and if you'd like to go, to take advantage of the pre-sale tickets that are out.
Go to overtenemy.com, sign up for the newsletter to get the latest information on their concert
right now, and purchase some tickets so you can get in. But it's looking to be a very great show, a lot of fun. We've always had a good time doing these past two concerts that we've had in the past, so it should be real good. Hopefully everybody can make it.
Hi, man. I wanted to ask you, what is your favorite song, your favorite original to perform of Overt Enemy?
I like Possession. It's a hard-hitting song, and it's real fast, and it's real aggressive, so I've always enjoyed that one. I think that's probably one of, well, it is my favorite. I like all of them, but that's my favorite one right now.
You're listening to Homebrewed, sponsored by 5x5 Brewing Company, located in Mission. And here on the line, I have Overt Enemy. On bass is Miss Laura Slayrella. And, you know, there's not that many women in metal bands, and you're kind of a standout. I wanted to ask you, do a lot of girls come up to you and ask you for advice and see you as a role model?
I get asked a lot, and I do get approached quite often by younger women. We're just starting out, just, you know, exploring the guitar, the bass, the drums, whatever. And they ask, you know, what they can expect getting out into the scene. And I always tell them, you know, just do your best. Do what feels right. Just express yourself. You want to be at the same level, if not surpass, some of your male counterparts, just to make sure that you have a place in the scene, you know? You want to be able to get down and dirty with the rest of the guys. You don't want to be seen as just a girl in the scene.
Right. You don't want it to be just a novelty. Hey, look, I'm in the band and I'm a girl. You want, you know, show your merit is what you're telling the females, right?
Exactly. Yes.
On the line, I have Overt Enemy, Mr. Rob Hahn. Tell me about the writing process for Overt Enemy.
Well, we all write together. Leo's definitely the riff lord and comes up with just a ton of killer riffs. He's always sending us stuff. He'll get home from work and send us a video on Facebook of an idea for a new song. And then, you know, we'll all get together and bang out different ideas. And then when we're ready to start writing lyrics, we'll a lot of times we collaborate on them. That's what we did with Possession. I think we came up with the title, and then Leo started coming up with some ideas for it, and we just kind of went back and forth on it. Leo, was that the one that we rode back and forth like in one day when I was driving to Laredo?
Yeah, we did it at Josh's, man. Remember during one of our sessions there?
Oh, that's
we were
right.
We were sitting outside during one of our jam session breaks, and we were like, hey, we need to get these lyrics done because that's the next song we're going to start putting together, this and that. So we sat outside, you know, behind a cigarette, and you and I were just shooting out just a ton of different ideas. And I remember we wanted to go in one direction, but then I was like, no, let's stay away from the common form of Possession and let's kind of reinvent it and, you know, rewrite it to where it makes more sense for the common people now, where, you know, we're more being possessed by our, you know, our technology and our devices and all this new space age crap that we never even knew we needed in the past.
Yeah,
that's where the ideas came for that one. And Rob and I, man, we sat out there till the wee hours of the morning writing this out. And, you know, I mean, it was amended and corrected, and we reworded a bunch of stuff, but the premise was there.
Yeah, so, like, what'll happen is we'll write it all down and then get in the studio, and Leo's the main singer, and, you know, I do backup vocals and double some stuff. And so we'll work out the cadences and be like, no, that those syllables don't work right there. What other word could we use that means the same thing, but it'll come out better, or, you know, be easier to sing and that kind of thing, because we have to sing and play guitar at the same time, which is not for the faint of heart in this genre. So Possession, it's all about the internet and technology is, you know, controlling everybody's mind, you know, the dopamine drips prepping the mind for Possession.
You're listening to Home Brewed, sponsored by 5x5 Brewing Company, located in Mission, Texas. And on the line, I've got Overt Enemy. And I want you guys to tell me, you guys have a lot of accomplishments, but what is the thing that you are the most proud of? And we'll start with you, Laura, on bass.
Yeah, my biggest accomplishment right now is the Possession EP. I'm just so proud that we were able to get that down and get it out for everybody. And the gone worldwide. We see people in Indonesia. We see people in New Zealand downloading our album. And I can't fathom people from, you know, across the world are listening to our stuff.
That's pretty, you know, that is pretty amazing to think that someone so far away in another country is listening to your music. Leo, what do you say?
I am the most proud of everybody's spirit in this band. We all come from hardworking families. None of us have been spoon-fed or given anything for free in our lives. We have our own families. We have our own problems. We have our own issues. But I'm the most proud of everyone's spirit and how we pull together. Even when it gets real, you know, and we're at our wit's end and we're arguing amongst each other, our spirit and our love for this band and for the music is still stronger than any other emotions that we have, and that is what is keeping us together, and that's what's keeping us writing. Yeah, that's what I'm most proud of. I'm most proud of the spirit in this band.
Nicely stated, Leo. Very philosophical. Yeah. Next is Jaime Ayala. By the way, Jaime, you have beautiful kids. I see them on Facebook all the time. And what are you most proud of when it comes to Overt Enemy?
Well, just being from the valley, being, you know, on this side of the state where it's, you know, not a lot of people are aware of. Every time you go up north, they're like, oh, you're from the valley, or you're from Edinburgh, or you're from, you know, this area. And they're like, I don't know where that is. But it's very inspiring and great to know that we're getting out there. And I love everybody in this band. their family. We've known each other for many, many years now, better part of 15 years plus. And it's great. It's great knowing that we all support each other. We all are there for each other whenever things get rough, whenever there's something good. We're there for each other too, good and the bad. Help each other out with families. If there's ever, if anybody's in need of something, we're all there for each other. So I love these guys with all my heart. And I'm so happy to just be in this band and also having our music out and people enjoying it and, you know, reaching out to us and letting us know that this music lifts them up whenever they're down or keeps them up whenever they're up or just makes them, you know, just proud. And they love the music that we're putting out. And also the fans that come up to us and tell us that they enjoy what we're doing and give us props and say that they enjoy our music. That means a lot to me. And I will always remember that. And I will always, we will always be very humble to everybody that we come across and be very appreciative of the fans and the family and friends that we meet throughout this trip that we're going on right now. So I'm very happy and I love you guys very much.
Thank you, Chaim. Finally, Rob, what would you like to add?
I would just add that when I think about our band, I think about the fact that we do what we say we're going to do. We always do what we say we're going to do, and we have an enormous amount of integrity. So, you know, when I joined the band, we all sat down together and, you know, we said, hey, let's be the best player tribute band in Texas, right? And I think we are that. With confidence. We've been told that we're, you know, one of the best, if not the best in North America. I mean, we've got a song on Liquid Metal, you know, that's a huge accomplishment, you know, for any band, right? And it's covering a Slayer song, which is a righteously difficult Slayer song as well, at Dawn They Sleep. So I'm very, very proud of the integrity that we show and always doing what we say we're going to do and rising to the occasion of every challenge. Because if you really think about it, I mean, we're like a true underdog story as a band. Okay. We're all over 30. We all have families and careers. We're not 20-year-old. So, you know, we've got a lot of things going on. It's pretty successful. People really like it. And we're playing music that's pretty hard to play, you know. I mean, there's no day at the park. It's not like playing Green Day or, you know, anything like that. And that's I think what I'm most proud of in this band is the amount of integrity that we have.
You're listening to Homebrewed, sponsored by 5x5 Brewing Company, located in Mission, Texas.
The RGV official rock station, Q94.5. All rock, all the time.